Hi guys, today I will show you how to control the home device to smartphone. Then you can make your smartphone very easily with Raspberry. The idea here is we can control your home device to external network and local Wifi network. So here I use relay 4 channel, then for the 4 pin the relay controlled by Raspberry CPL pin. This type of relay I use is 8 times the CPL pin move to low level, it will active relay. So here for 4 relay, you can connect to live, fan or air condition, depend on your project. And we will control device via smartphone. So how to control the relay and connection? Here you have to connect. Here I use 5-volt relay. You need to connect power supply for the relay and common power supply from Raspberry and relay. We have 4 control channel. Connect to Raspberry pin. From relay output, you can see here. We need to connect like this, and each time control channel activates, the switch will close and the main power supply will go to your device and activate the device. Go to the code. Here we need to separate two applications, one in Raspberry Pi as a server and one in smart device. Here I use Android platform. So from the smartphone we can control the home device through the even external or internal network. So go to the client application programming. As you can see here, need to make one kind of layout. Here we have switch button to switch between external and internal network. The purpose for internal network is if you are in the home, you can switch to internal, then the controller speed much faster because it just controlled via over Wi-Fi. So with external, we have idea that we will send the email to Raspberry to add the command to Raspberry and control the device. For this example, I create 4 switch with the control line, 2 line and 1 air condition and 1 fence. And also you need to set up 1 client email, and this one you keep the, your password client email and also the email of the Raspberry. So idea is you send each time you press the button here, the command will send by the email to Raspberry email. That is in external case. So in case of internal If you switch to internal, then Raspberry just send command via the Wi-Fi by the local Raspberry IP address. So as you can see the code here, firstly we need to design for switch some text field to get the email string and password, and with each time we click to the switch, you can see here if we check the switch for the network, if external we will send email to the Raspberry, and if network is internal we just send via the Wi-Fi. Detail about the send email method and send Wi-Fi you can see at the previous video. So same thing we do with the switch 2, switch 3 and switch 4. Here we have the send email methods, and also we have send Wi-Fi command methods. So move to server application. We need two apps here. First one is we receive the command from Wi-Fi. So with this one we just define the host port and address, then we will waiting for the TCP socket from the client device sent to Raspberry and check the string we received. So as you can see here, if string receive 0, here is we have the right here with line 1 on, we will switch the line. Here I define that the line 1 is set pin 29 and like 2 with 31 and fan 33 and air 35. So okay, go to simulation. I will show you here. So I need to switch to the internal network. Let's see. Each time I press. For Raspberry, we receive the command. Then move to the second server application on that grid. With this one, he will receive the command from the email. As you can see here, we need to set up client email both the code to receive the email, and we have also have the check email method. We need to log in with the server email. You can use a Gmail to use this guy email method. So after log in the email will check in and will share from the client email here. You need to type correctly the client email. Then after that we check the all the email received and receive from the client email to check. So same as Wi-Fi, we check one by one case to control the relay. As you can see here, we also have same 7 cases, 8 cases to switch the home device. Island Motor Simulation. And you see, here you external network, right? You have to move down to external network. Then we need to control. Then we will control. See, you send one command to Raspberry. See, read it off. Okay, this one. See, then turn on line 1, line 2.
Okay, let's connect on the Raspberry. Let's see here. It will use this 4 pin for the control relay, and we also supply power from 5 volt and 3.3 volts. Have the relay board like this. We connect power from Raspberry to the relay control board and CND here, and we have 4 input pin here. So let's connect. So from Raspberry we disconnect 4 CPIO pin. So after that, you need to connect the power into the relay control board. Here we have the GND pin. Let's connect together here. So this one is a GND for board. Control board and common GND for Raspberry, and we need to connect this one.
Give me permission to help you.
Yeah. We need to connect to the GND here. Okay. Then now we need to connect power for the relay board. For VCC, we need to connect to 3.3 volt from Raspberry. Yeah, this pin. And remain for the enough for the relay power. We need to connect to 5 volt. You can connect from Raspberry or the outside external power is okay, no problem. But I recommend to connect to outside power. It's much safety for Raspberry. Okay, so now we have on connection smartphone. We open the control from smartphone. Then firstly I will check in the internal ones. This one you need to use Wi-Fi. Okay, let me try to switch. Sí. So to run, you need to make ensure that we need to run the two files in background from the server. These two files need to run from Raspberry to receive command from smartphone. So here you can see when we control in Raspberry in the smartphone, you can receive the command here. Okay, now I will switch to external network to ensure that I will disable the Wi-Fi. Then I will make sure that everything is external network. Here we use the mobile network. So we switch to external. Let's see. So you need to wait some time to receive command. And you can see, take around 10 seconds from sending command to Raspberry, because we use external network and a little bit slow.
Thanks for your watching. Like and subscribe to follow and support channel.